हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 897 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ पेन्स दैट इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एप्लीकेशन पार्ट टू एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट द पेन्स दे आर द मिक्सचर ऑफ पिगमेंट्स डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पिगमेंट्स डिफरेंट कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स एंड they are classified as per their demand, their desire and their application. Somewhere we need to apply the paint to protect from radiation. Somewhere we apply the paint in order to reflect the radiation. Somewhere we apply the paint to get luminance, phosphorescent, that is known as luminous paint, metallic paint, emulsion paint and some other paints which are needed to reflect the ultraviolet light, and cement paint where we are mixing the paints with cement with different color in white cement, and latex paint where vegetable protein is isolated and it is mixed to make the coating of the paint. So there are lot of different type of paints which are classified on the basis of their requirement and application. So some I have already discussed and few I am going to discuss here one by one. So these paints which are given here, they are manufactured by mixing different ingredients as per our requirement. So number one is, that is known as luminous paints. This luminous paints, these paints consist of phosphorescent paint compositions and such as pigments, the sulfide of calcium, cadmium and zinc, and they are dispersed in spirit varnish and they give phosphorescent paint. The vehicle is, that is medium of dispersion, is chlorinated rubber or sterol, and sensitizer for activation in UV region is also used. Number two, that is known as marine paints. This is also known as anti-fouling paint and can be prepared by mixing various ingredients such as pigments, zinc oxide and vanadium red. Also resin, that is Shela, dryers is MN linoleate, vehicle is colta, and diluent is pineal. Toxic components are cuprous oxide and mercurous or mercuric oxide, and a small amount of bees wax, that honey bees wax. Number three, emulsion paints. These paints contain an emulsion of alkyds and phenyl formaldehydes. They are used as vehicle, and in water the pigments are added and extenders are also added to get desired properties. These paints are highly durable, impermeable to dirt, rapidly drying, contain water as a thinner and can be easily cleaned. So this is a popular paint that is known as emulsion paints, because emulsion is formed with water, pigment ingredient in presence of that is formaldehyde and phenol. Number four, latex paint. These paints usually contain protein dispersion that can be prepared by stirring soybean proteins or casein in aqueous ammonia solution for about an hour, and the pigments are added and the extenders are added, that is
clay and talc, barium sulfate, these are extenders, and the preservative is pentachlorophenol. The pigments are zinc sulfide and titanium dioxide. They are dispersed in water. Anti-foaming agent is also added, that is your pine oil, and plasticizer is added, that is your tributyl phosphate, and latex is prepared from butadiene-styrene copolymer in water, and all these ingredients are thoroughly mixed and stirred, and then finally packed in the form of latex paint. So number 5 is, that is aluminium paints. These paints are used as heat reflecting paints and consist of pigment, that is your aluminium powder in the form of pigment, and vehicle is spirit varnishes and cellulose nitrate liquids. Number 6, metal paints. These are coating applied on the metal surface our bodies for protection and decoration purposes, and this coating may be of barrier type or galvanic types, and these consist of pigment vehicle, anti-corrosive agent like zinc or chrome yellow. This zinc and chrome yellow, they are anti-corrosive agents, and resin is alkyds, epoxy, polyamides, chlorinated rubbers, and silicones. Number 7, what are alkyds? They resist weathering of metals. Epoxy, polyamides form tough film, are resistant to chemicals. Chlorinated rubbers resist the action of soap, detergents, and strong oxidizing agent, as well as strong chemicals. Zinc coating is an example of galvanization to protect from corrosion. Number 8, cement paints. These paints are prepared by mixing white coloring matters or pigments, hydrated lime, and fine sand as inert filler. Cement paints are available in the form of powder of particular color. The dispersion medium may be water or an oil. In case of stone or brick structure, the dispersion medium is water, but sometimes we are using boiled linseed also used as a dispersion medium. Before applying cement paints, a primary coat consisting of dilute solution of sodium silicate and zinc sulfate is a must. What is distemper? Is common word. Distemper are water paints. There are water paints consisting of pigments, may be white, may be color, remy green color, and this is in water. And paint, and it has good covering power. So with this, your classification of paints on the basis of its requirement and application is over. Now I will be discussing the very complex constituents of paint, because paint industry is having lot of mixing of different type of ingredients, and they are very interesting, and that's why it is very complex and it needs lot of chemistry knowledge to prepare good paint. Otherwise the manufacture of paint is failure if you are not very clear in their chemical constituents. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.